Spirit.
We gather as a community to continue to celebrate the great mystery of Christmas today, as we all know, is the feast of the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Jesus, the Son of the Most High God, is born into a family like all of us. We know that it is the family that shapes us and helps us ultimately to grow in our relationship with one another. Pray in a special way for all of our families. We ask now the Lord to help us to enter into these sacred mysteries by acknowledging our sins and asking the Lord for pardon and strength. And as a community and as persons, we confess, I confess to
Almighty God.
Bring us to a
Amen.
The reading from the book of Genesis. The word of the Lord came to Abraham in vision, saying, "Fear not, Abraham. I am your shield. I will make your reward very great." But Abraham said, "O Lord God, what good will your gifts be if I keep on being childless and have as my heir the steward of my house Eliezer?" Abraham continued, "See, you have given me no offspring, and so one of my servants will be my heir." Then the word of the Lord came to him, "No, that one shall not be your heir. Your own issue shall be your heir." The Lord took Abraham outside and said, "Look up at the sky and count the stars if you can. Just so," he added, "shall be your descendants." Abraham put his faith in the Lord, who credited to him as an act of righteousness. The Lord took note of Sarah, as he had said he would. He did for her as he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore Abraham a son in his old age, at the set time that God had stated. Abraham gave the name Isaac to his son, of his whom Sarah bore him. The word of the Lord. He went out, not knowing where he was to go. By faith, he received power to generate even though he was past the normal age, and Sarah herself was strong. For he thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man himself, as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sands on the seashore. By faith, Abraham, when put to the test, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises was ready to offer his only son, of whom it was said, through Isaac, descendants shall bear your name. He reasoned that God was able to raise even from the dead, and he received Isaac back as a symbol. The word of the Lord.
Now, finally, now, you
sometimes feel somewhat humble too, because try as I might, I don't think I can say that phrase with the same conviction that Simeon said it and really mean it. I have to admit that I find myself a little bit envious, a little bit of Simeon. I would love to be able to say that with the same conviction that he was able to say it. You know, and I don't think I'm alone in being attracted to Simeon's freedom. For I suppose there are many, many, many of us, perhaps some of us here, who have always wanted to be able to say that, but still have not been able to say it fully. I was thinking of a father who died while his children were still young. That's not an easy thing for any person to face. And at his bedside, he was agitated, and he was unable to talk. And a friend asked him if he was worried about his wife and children, and he nodded, yes. The friend told him that his family would miss him, but they would be well. To which he held up his two fingers, his index finger and his middle finger crossed, a clear sign that means, hope so. No song of Simeon for him. Now you can let your servant go in peace for him. We know how deep bargaining can go on within us. A parent prays to stay longer in the world until a child has overcome a problem, or until a child has found a spouse, or until a grandchild is born. And don't we all harbor a deep hope that one day all of us will be ready? We will be so fully invested in life's feast, so satisfying our deepest hungers, that in satisfying this deepest hunger, we realize that there is no more that we need to realize. We can begin slowly to let go of our tight grip and begin to let go and to surrender into this next stage of living. Some years ago, I remember a film called The Bucket List. I don't know if any of you saw that film. It's a story of two men, Jack Nicholson and Morgan Freeman. Freedom are the two characters. They realize also that their time is short, but they too are far from being ready to depart in peace. And they come to believe that their shot at singing the Song of Simeon is by experiencing a bucket list of things they want to do before they kick the bucket. And so they embark on a series of adventures that include skydiving, driving race cars — I guess they always wanted to drive a race car — driving a motorcycle on the Great Wall of China. I don't think that's legal, actually. And they take an exotic trip to Italy, where Morgan Freeman's character asks Jack Nicholson's character, "Got kids?" And he responds, "I don't see her anymore," is what Jack Nicholson's character says. So he comes to realize in Italy that part of his bucket list involves reconciling broken or strained relationships, both in life and especially in family. Being reconciled, perhaps, with other people might lead us in the direction of being able to sing the Song of Simeon. You know, I liked that film. I'm sure probably some of you have seen it and liked it too. But I wondered to myself if fulfilling a list of experiences on a bucket list really ensures the human heart and leads us to be able to sing the Song of Simeon. To my way of thinking, I don't think it fully does, no matter how wonderful the experiences we have. I want to return just briefly to the gospel today, because there's a little indication of what maybe helped Simeon really sing that song of farewell. He said, "Now you can let your," what's the word?
Servant.
Let your servant go in peace. And maybe it's not so much fulfilling the bucket list of experiences that helps us to go in peace, but perhaps it's becoming a servant of God, a servant to one another. Perhaps it's being the servant that helps the person depart in peace. Maybe other people just stop, but the servant moves forward. Why are you thinking also it goes deeper than as important as service is? I was thinking perhaps another thing that will help us to grow in our singing the Song of Simeon virtues that St. Paul highlights in that second reading. It's important for all of us to know that we are God's chosen ones, God's beloved. Wouldn't that be helpful if we really knew that and lived that? Wouldn't that sort of help us to sing the song of Simeon? How about daily putting on heartfelt compassion and kindness and gentleness? And how about bearing with one another? Especially those people perhaps that can be a little bit of a pain in our necks or something. Could that help us perhaps to move in the direction of singing the song of Simeon? How about living forgiveness? How about putting on love? How about letting the peace of Christ control our hearts? And how about living thankfully? Those are the virtues that are on Paul's bucket list. I wonder if that might be the way that we can begin to move in the direction of singing the song of Simeon. Now you can let your servant go in peace. Today is the feast, as you know, of the Holy Family. We know that Jesus was raised by his father and mother, Joseph and Mary, in the faith of their ancestors to really realize. But I imagine it was in that family context where there was the experience of compassion, where there was the experience of kindness and gentleness, where Jesus learned how to bear with one another, even in the context of his family, where forgiveness was extended. You know, my sense is that if we're living those things, if we're becoming that servant, and if we are living those virtues that St. Paul calls us to, I think we will become more and more a holy family in our own way, because there's no perfect families in this world, but we can grow in holiness over the course of the years, where we can really consciously say, well, as an act of love, I am going to bear with one another. I'm going to forgive. I'm going to put on love. I'm going to let peace govern my heart. And perhaps, too, if we live those things, being a servant and living those virtues in family, we might just find ourselves a little less gripped to needing life to be in a certain way. We can begin to relax some of our need to be in control. And perhaps with Simeon, sing that beautiful phrase, now you can let your servant go.
Thank you.
grounded in the hope and aspirations life brings, as well as its joys and responsibilities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let single people find welcome in our parish family and live out their vocation through lives of charity, prayer, and service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sake, John Cabrera, Mariana Calabrino, Jameson Swing, Thomas Mueller, George Brutus, and those listed in the bulletin, that the Lord will restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those that have died in the peace of Christ, Leroy Thomas, Anthony Valero, Marianne Pearson, Kimberly Saver, Christina Sharp, Robert Salis, Gladys Hugo Munoz, Jose Tavares Tavares, Louis F. Pizarro, Elvira Nicoletti, Nicholas Nassiti, and especially for Giuseppe Scherer, that they may be welcome into the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Faithful God, you offer us your Son Jesus that we might share your life. Hear our prayers and give answer through the same Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim.
Scattered throughout the world.
we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Thank you.
Saturday at 9 a.m. as usual. I mean, also wanted to thank everyone who helped out and gave us some sort of donation, gift, or food for the breakfast with Jesus yesterday. It was a big, big success. A lot of people came. A lot of families went home with food, and a lot of kids especially went home with toys. So again, thank you for all of your assistance and for everything that you did to make sure that this worked out perfectly, which it did. And also, there is a movement called America Needs Fatima, which is a movement that tries to promote the prayer of the Rosary, the Holy Rosary of the Blessed Mother. And tomorrow they're having another initiative where part of the initiative is that they, especially during Christmas time, that people pray the Rosary in front of the nativity scene in their churches. So for us, that's going to be tomorrow here in the church at 3 p.m. We're going to gather here in the church to pray the Rosary in front of the nativity scene. So please, if you can't join us, I know a lot of people are working, a lot of you are working from home, so don't give me that excuse. But hopefully, again, if you can, we'll meet you here so we can all pray the Rosary together. And as always, thank you, Father Kelly. Merry Christmas to you and to all the Mary and all fathers. Thank you. God bless you.